phenomenal cosmic power.
Ah, Disney. I love it, and whether you're willing to admit it or not, so do you. Chances are, Disney has played a huge part in your childhood and likely still plays a large part in your life now. To me, Disney is happiness. Just watching one of their movies or being in one of their theme parks is a feeling I really can't get anywhere else. But what happens when you want to experience that magic firsthand and play it? Well, luckily for you, Disney has been making video games for about as long as video games have been shown to be profitable. Disney's all about the monies. There's tons of Disney-based video games, and while most of them range from bad to mediocre, there's a lot of really good ones, too. And I think this is the perfect time to talk about them, because this has been a pretty big couple of months for Disney games. The Castle of Illusion remake was just released a few days ago, and Ducktales Remastered, a remake of probably the most popular Disney game ever, came out last month, and is actually really good. But most important of all was the release of Disney Infinity, Disney's attempt to sort of change how you view games and toys, and while it might not do that, it is really good. I mean, the toy box mode is just too cool. You can really do anything. Like, look, here I am as Mater driving around in Scrooge McDuck's money bin. Whee! How do I get out of here? And here's my art farm. It's where I keep my arts. I'll just add a couple of these and... perfect. So, as you can see, now is as good of a time as ever to talk about what I consider to be the 10 best Disney games. But before I get into the list, I want to set up some ground rules. First of all, the games on this list are all based on Disney properties that originated in film or TV or whatever. Disney has had some original video game IPs like Spectrobes, Where's My Water, and Split Second, but none of those are included on this list. Apologies to all three fans of each of those games out there. Also, Kingdom Hearts is being omitted from the list. It focuses mainly on original characters to tell the story, and honestly, I love Kingdom Hearts so much that at least four games from that series would be on the list if I included them, so we're leaving Kingdom Hearts off the list. Apologies to all 3 billion fans of that series out there. Now that that's out of the way, let's get to it. This is Adam at Ditto's Top 10 Best Disney Game.
Number 10.
Toy Story 3. It only makes sense that the game that inspired the game that inspired this list would make an appearance, and here it is. Toy Story 3 is one of those rare modern-day examples of a movie license game that's actually pretty good. The game's main story is just a basic retelling of the movie's plot, where you play as Woody, Buzz, and Jessie, platforming through various levels and playing minigames and stuff. It's well executed, but it's basic. It wouldn't be on this list for the main story. The real draw of the game is the Toy Box mode. The Toy Box mode is an open-world adventure where you go around this Old West-themed area doing missions, building buildings, and collecting items. It's not especially deep, but there's a lot to do, and since it's open-world, you can do it at your own pace. It's fun, and it opened the doors for the entire premise of Disney Infinity, so I have to give credit where credit is due.
Number 9.
Goof Troop. Some of you who have actually bothered to follow us outside of YouTube might recall that a ways back, I did a top 10 list on our blog about Disney games. It looks entirely different than this one because I put way more effort into this, but anyway, that's irrelevant. Originally, I had Chip 'n Dale Rescue Rangers listed as the best multiplayer game that Disney had. I lied to you. While Rescue Rangers is a fantastic game, Goof Troop is where it's at. Goof Troop is a strange game. It's like a multiplayer, top-down action puzzle game that takes all the best elements from games like Zelda and Mole Mania, yeah, who's heard of that one, and mixes it with Disney Afternoon antics. There's nothing else really like it, and I think that's what makes it so wonderful. It's all about teamwork, working together as father and son to stop the evil pirates and find a bunch of gems and grappling hooks. I don't remember that episode of the show, but hey, it makes for a great game anyway.
Number 8.
Toy Story Racer. Probably the most obscure game on the list, Toy Story Racer is a kart racing game released late in the PS1's lifespan, starring a bunch of characters from the first Toy Story movie, even though the second one was already out, but hey, whatever, what other game can you play as both Lenny and Babyface? None. Exactly. While this game could have very easily been a very lazy Mario Kart ripoff, like so many other racing games at the time, the team at Traveler's Tales made it unique by giving the game a sort of mission-based setup. Instead of racing in your typical Grand Prix like any other racing game, in order to unlock new characters, modes, and tracks, you had to complete different missions as each character. These range from Mario Kart-style battle modes to 8-lap races where a different racer is eliminated one by one each lap until a victor is crowned. It's an interesting setup and a lot of fun to play. It is disappointing that you only have 4 characters to start with in the multiplayer mode, since every other character needs to be unlocked, but it's fun unlocking them, so I'll let it slide. If you've never played this game, or ever heard of this game, and have 5 bucks to spare, this game is actually available on the PlayStation Network right now. I'd recommend it if you're a fan of good kart racing games.
Number 7.
Castle of Illusion, starring Mickey Mouse. Now, I know what you're thinking. How can one of the most iconic games of the Genesis library only be number 7 on my list? Because it's my list, that's why. Castle of Illusion is a great 2D platformer. It really is, but I think Disney had so much better in their catalog during the 16-bit era. But we'll get there later. Anyway, Castle of Illusion is a whimsical little game that brings out all these happy feelings anytime I play it. The stages are colorful and unique, the music is cheery, and you get to bop on toy soldiers' heads. Mickey looks a little weird though. Something about the sprite just seems off. He looks better in the sequel, but man, he just looks weird. Anyway, Castle of Illusion is a classic, and it definitely deserves to be considered one, but I still think there's better options out there. But that doesn't mean you shouldn't check out one of Mickey's finest starring roles.
Number 6!
Magical Quest, starring Mickey Mouse. Speaking of Mickey's finest starring roles, here's what I consider to be the best. While many people consider the Castle of Illusion series on the Genesis to be the definitive Mickey Mouse series, I think Magical Quest on the Super Nintendo has it beat. I think the graphics are slicker, the stages are more clever, and the use of the many different power-ups make for a much more unique and fun game. You can wear a firefighter outfit to squirt enemies with water, and this weird Peter Pan outfit which allows Mickey to swing around like Rad Spencer, and all the levels are built around these abilities. The game might be a tad bit harder than Castle of Illusion, but that doesn't make it any worse. I actually think it's the best game with Mickey's name in the title, so make of that what you will.
Number 5!
Toy Story. Whoa! Look at those graphics! It's like we're watching the movie right now! Yes, Toy Story on the Super Nintendo and Genesis was a very impressive looking game. Borrowing from the Donkey Kong Country series, using CG renders to make sprites that look like they were ripped right from the movie. And not only does the game look great, but it plays great too. It doesn't really do anything to change how you view 2D platformers, but it's one of the better ones of the genre. Whipping toy trains and planes with Woody's pull string is both clever and satisfying, and the game occasionally breaks into a few other gameplay styles to keep things fresh. There's stages where you race as RC, run really fast on Rex's back, and even a level where you have to hide under Pizza Planet cups. It's pretty funny. It's also a really hard game. The stage where you have to ride on Roller Bob is one of the hardest stages in any game I've ever played. I still can't beat it without cheating. I don't know if that's a testament to the game or just further proof that I'm terrible at everything, but either way, Toy Story is one great, if not frustrating, Disney game. Also, I'm fully aware of the irony of saying I wouldn't put Kingdom Hearts on here because it would take up 4 spots and then fill 3 spots with Toy Story games, but you know what? Maybe if Kingdom Hearts had Toy Story in it, things would be different. Think about that, Square. I know you're watching.
Number 4!
The Lion King. When it comes to great-looking games on the Super Nintendo and Genesis, The Lion King, in my opinion, looks even better than Toy Story. While Toy Story might be technically superior, The Lion King is far more colorful and has more personality, thanks to the sprites being designed by the same people that worked on the movie. That, to me, is nuts, but hey, I'm glad it happened. The Lion King, like most games on the list, is a 2D platformer where you take control of Simba as he grows up and eventually reclaims his kingdom from the evil Scar. When playing as Cub Simba, all you can do is jump on things and growl. It actually makes his stages some of the more difficult in the game because once you grow up, you get a claw attack, which makes killing enemies much easier. Not that the game is easy, in fact, it's really hard. The very second stage still gives me trouble to this day. Stupid monkeys. And the stage where you have to jump on logs to get up a waterfall? Forget about it! But being hard doesn't make it bad, and I think The Lion King is a great example of that. It's an excellent platformer that I think all fans of Disney games, or 2D platformers in general, should give a try.
Number 3!
Aladdin, both the Super Nintendo version and the Genesis version. That's right, I'm including both Aladdin for the Super Nintendo and the Genesis on this list in the same spot. Why? Because again, it's my list, and honestly, who am I to try to decide a victor for a feud that's been going on for 20 years? It's rare that a multi-platform game of the same name based on the same property is different on both consoles it was released for, but Aladdin was just that. The SNES version was developed by Capcom, while the Genesis version was developed by Virgin, and both are entirely different games. The Super Nintendo version is more reliant on platforming and jumping on enemies, while the Genesis version gives you a sword to focus on combat. Both games have excellent level design, and are both good enough to deserve a spot on this list. The Super Nintendo version might sound better, and the Genesis version definitely looks better, but I think they both play great, and both have their merits. They also both have rental-stopping magic carpet levels, so clearly both designers were unholy spawns of the devil who did not care about the children that would be playing these games. Of all the games on this list, the Aladdin games might be the most well-known, simply because they've been fanboy fuel over which is better, Super Nintendo or Genesis, for years now. Honestly, I don't think we'll ever know which is better, and that's okay with me, because both of these games are simply diamonds in the rough.
Number 2!
Darkwing Duck. Hey kids, do you like Mega Man but wish it involved more Disney? Well, Darkwing Duck is the game for you! Developed by Capcom and released in 1992, Darkwing Duck puts you in control of the terror that flaps in the night as you make your way through St. Canard fighting all of Darkwing's most iconic villains, except Negaduck for some reason. The game was built on the Mega Man engine and it shows. You run, you jump, you shoot, you collect power-ups, though not from bosses. But hey, the Mega Man games are great and so is this game. In fact, I'd say it's better than some of the actual Mega Man games. It looks great, it sounds great, everything about this game is great. I love it, and in my opinion, there's only one Disney game better.
Number 1!
Ducktales. Did you really expect it to be anything else? I mean, this is the game that was just remade despite the fact that Disney stopped caring about the Ducktales franchise 20 years ago. That's how good this game is. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. When it comes to the NES, not even Nintendo themselves knew how to make games using the NES to the best of its abilities quite like Capcom did. And DuckTales might be the finest example of that. Okay, Mega Man 2 through 6 are the best examples of that, but DuckTales is close! It was a sort of bizarre 2D platformer. It was non-linear in that you could not only select which level you wanted to play, but you could also explore them at your own will. There were secrets, sure, but only a few of them were required. The pogo mechanic is still one of the most unique of the NES. Pressing down in the action button would bust out Scrooge's pogo cane that could be used for bashing enemies, bouncing on spikes, and tossing boulders, golf style, into hidden treasure chests. It's a really unique system, and I think it's one of the reasons DuckTales has had the legacy that it does. Well, that and the music. You already know this, but every single track in this game is pure classic, to the point where I've heard people say it's the best soundtrack of any NES game. And honestly, I don't think they're far off. There's a reason DuckTales was Capcom's best-selling NES game in the US. It's a fantastic platformer that still holds up to this day. The remake is a fantastic trip down nostalgia lane, but nothing will ever top the original. Can I get a woohoo? Woohoo! Well, that's it for my top 10 Disney games, but as some of you faithful Shiny Dittos out there may recall, in preparation for this list, I asked the viewers to share their opinions of the best Disney game on Facebook, Twitter, and our forums. Of all the Disney games suggested, Toy Story 2, Buzz Lightyear to the Rescue, definitely received the most votes, and I can see why. It's one of the better 3D platformers out there, and I think it still holds up pretty well today. Lilo and Stitch for the Game Boy Advance also received quite a few votes, as did the flawed but very atmospheric Epic Mickey for the Wii. And the good Disney games don't stop there. There's still a few even I left out, like Rescue Rangers, The Little Mermaid, Kim Possible 2, and, surprisingly, almost all of the Cars games. But I can't put everything on the list, can I? Hopefully, Disney continues to make use of quality games like DuckTales Remastered and Disney Infinity, and make some more classics in the coming years. I can definitely see Disney Infinity growing and becoming the best Disney game of all time. It just needs a little bit more of that Disney magic the rest of the games on this list have. Hey, thanks for watching this thing I did. Now, if you enjoyed it, why don't you subscribe to our channel and like and favorite this video or something like that. You don't have to do all three, but one or the other would be good. And if Disney's your thing, check out some of these Let's Plays we did of some Disney games. But if you only watch this video because it's a list, we have some lists you can enjoy as well. And when you're done with that, why don't you go spend some money in our shirt shop?